Today, I would like to show you a technical innovation for our old two-stroke engines, the SMARTCARB. The SMARTCARB is a high-tech carburetor from America, and it comes with huge promises. Those are first, to increase power output, lower emissions, lower fuel consumption, and automatically adjust to variations in height. To reach these goals, the maker promises a particularly fine atomization. They promise the carb can be set up without jets, and that it automatically adjusts to changes in air pressure by equalizing pressure in the flood bowl. One thing first, forget the increase in power. Well, don't forget it. It is nice. In our test, we too had a slight increase in power. But for me personally, that's not the main reason to buy a SMARTCARB. What's really cool about that carburetor is that they are extremely easy to tune, that they work really well, that throttle response is excellent, and first and foremost, that it automatically adjusts to changes in air pressure. I will now show you how that is done technically. What it looks like inside the carb, that's what I will briefly explain. There are only two sizes of bodies, by the way. The small one with 25 and 28 venturi size, and the large body with 36 and 40. And here is the needle, the only tuning part of the carb, which, by the way, SMARTCARB calls rod. First thing I would like to show you how adjustments work. SMARTCARB claims that, in principle, the carb can be tuned without getting off the scooter. And that works as follows. You lift the slide to its maximum, with the engine not running, of course, and then you push this knurled screw up here down. By doing so, you connect the setting mechanisms of the needle, and then you can set the rod in height, and thus you make the carb run leaner and richer over the working range. The only thing that is changed is the height of the rod. I will now show you what this rod looks like. What immediately springs to mind is that the rod, or the needle, does not taper to a point towards the end, as it does in a regular carb, but that it has a flat section and tapers down above it. So the ring gap is larger with the slide at wide open throttle than it is with the slide down. Another very interesting feature of the SMARTCARB is the automatic compensation of changes in pressure. That's not only cool when riding in the Alps, it also helps when the weather changes hugely. If, for instance, you set up the carb on a Sunday with nice weather, and then you want to ride to work on Monday with the temperature down 10 degrees, this compensation of pressure changes is quite straightforward in principle. You can see two holes here in the bell mouth, both in the large and in the small carb, and they are connected to the flood bowl. This makes for an automatic compensation for pressure changes. On the other hand, that means the flood bowl needs to be closed, hence it doesn't have no overflow lines. The only hose you see here, it is used to level the float, which is very important prior to installing the carb. Now, a brief demonstration of how the carb looks inside. The flood bowl here too is held up by four Allen bolts. They can be opened quickly. Oops. As you can see easily, there really are no jets. Here would be the atomizer and the main jet in other carbs. You see, there is no jet. Not sure the camera captures it, but maybe we can see the gap inside the bore getting larger. So now, when opening the throttle, the gap gets larger. There also is a float. I've removed it already though.
Aufgelöst.
Nothing more to see really. That's all I wanted to show you. When you see the carbs, what catches the eye is their sheer size. That's mainly because they are CNC made out of billet. I've brought you two popular carbs to compare and see how big they are, and to see whether you may have a space issue. One is a Del Orto VHS carburetor and a Mikuni PWK. Now, I'll measure the carbs in comparison. I'll start with the height, without the throttle adjustment. The PWK is 152 mm in height. The Del Orto VHS carb is 163, and the 40 mm SMARTCARB is 159 mm.
Der SMARTCARB, der 40 mm SMARTCARB, hat 100
So it is in between the two carbs. What's important for many is the length of the carbs. That's how much space is needed between inked manifold and cover, panel, or whatever. The PWK is 91 millimeters. The VHS is 86 millimeters in length. SMART CARB has a length of 83 millimeters. So it actually is the shortest of the three carbs. What remains for the fitting of the carb is the width. Let's start with the Del Orto. This is a really very slim carb. The flat bowl is not the widest part on this one. I'll measure across the connections. It's 68 millimeters. The PWK across the flat bowl is 77 millimeters, and the SMART CARB is 71.5 millimeters wide. Again, it's right in between the other two. No carb is as compact as the Del Orto. Still, it is quite small, contrary to what one may think at first glance. So what do you need a SMART CARB for? The carburetor is anything but cheap. So the question is, are its features worth the money? Okay, I'm a lazy guy and often my carbs are not tuned to perfection. I work on them as long as I'm in the mood, and often that is not very long. Hence, a carb like that is great for people like me, and actually quite cheap, since blowing up the engine once with a badly tuned carb and the SMART CARB is cheaper than the PWK, for instance. The other thing I find attractive is how smooth the engine runs, the excellent throttle response. But will that also work on the road? That's what we tested for you. Today, we have a special guest here at SIP. This is Jürgen. Jürgen built a 306 BFA engine for himself, and he developed a box exhaust for it, which ran rather well. With this, he had 50 bhp. Now, he has downgraded it a bit because he rides his scooter daily, up and down mountains. So he has also fitted a smaller carb, lowered compression, retarded the ignition, and now he's here at SIP and we have tested how the engine is running. The result was 41-something bhp. A lovely power curve for everyday use, very rideable, and all that with a 30 mm Del Orto PHW carburetor. What we have done now is, we have fitted a 28 mm SMART CARB. We haven't even started the engine yet, and we will now test how the whole setup works. That now was a complete cold test. We simply stuck the carb on, nothing else. That's in comparison to the carb that was on there before, meticulously tuned. We made three runs to see how performance changes with temperature. I'll now compare the third run with the old carb with the third run with the new carb. What we now see is a slight increase low down, slightly more peak power and also better over rev. That's not bad for a carb that's only been slammed on. What's more important though, with the SMART CARB, for me at least, is throttle response, or the impression how the engine runs. And that's something Jürgen is better qualified, because he's better acquainted with the engine and knows better what's what. Well, I was really surprised that it ran so well. First kick, take over okay, and when you crack the throttle open, throttle response is amazing. Much better than before with the PHW with the 30 mm Del Orto. And I've also looked at quarter and half throttle. It ran much better immediately, I would say. Sounded lovely. I mean, I'm really surprised that it runs so well, without any tuning of the carb. We need to test that on the road, of course. But the first impression, really, I'm positively surprised. I wouldn't have expected that. I'm really happy with that. This test was completely cold, no setting up or anything. What you have just seen is banging on the carb and then cracking the throttle open on the dyno. I'd say with that in mind, we really are happy with the start. So we'll say goodbye for now and continue with a bit of playing. Bye.